Hi guys, welcome to another video by TechSepts.
In this TechSept, we are going to talk about MATLAB Coder. Let's get straight into business.
So, we know that MATLAB is a programming language and a numeric computing platform. But, what is MATLAB Coder?
Okay, the coder is a functionality that exists in MATLAB to convert MATLAB functions into other programming languages, especially into portable and readable C or C++ codes. We can use the MATLAB Coder add-on or the command line interface to do this.
So, why would someone need MATLAB Coder? Why not code directly in C or C++?
It's because in some industrial project environments as well as in educational projects, engineers and students use MATLAB for its superior capability of simulations to generate algorithms and test it. But when they want to transfer that project into a whole different language, like C to implement, they can easily use this MATLAB Coder functionality, which is built within the software itself.
So, what are some of the advantages of using MATLAB Coder rather than porting the code manually? Or should I say, free writing the entire code in the other language?
Because otherwise, someone has to spend time manually writing the same designs to C and C++. And since these languages are much different, there can be many functional differences that you have to cope up with. That means you have to maintain two separate projects that are not automatically synced with each other. So if your requirement changes during the development process, which happens almost all the time, then it's quite hard to go back and modify the already written codes and test it all over again to ensure that functionality is the same as the original MATLAB algorithm. Also, coding errors usually happen when someone performs the translation manually instead of happening it automatically, which leads to longer testing time and no guarantee that C and C++ code will perform the expected design. Finally, the whole manual process is time-consuming and costly, and it's expensive to handle algorithms in two different languages.
Sounds quite useful, to be honest. So, what are some of the use cases of MATLAB Coder?
If you have existing functions in MATLAB, it will provide a platform to convert those codes into C or C++ automatically. Also, it can be used to generate the MATLAB executable file, commonly known as MEX file, to speed up the executable process. You can directly use the generated C or C++ code from MATLAB Coder to deploy on other embedded hardware like Arduino, Raspberry Pi, and Jetson platforms. This can ultimately speed up your workflow, increase the executable performance, and eliminate the coding errors introduced by the manual translation process. It can generate a standalone executable that runs independently of MATLAB on your computer as well, like Windows.exe files.
But you might be wondering whether Coder supports MATLAB toolboxes too, like image processing and computation.
Coder supports most of the MATLAB functions from a wide range of toolboxes, including image processing, computer vision, signal processing, and communication. But there are some limitations when using the MATLAB Coder. It does not support all the functions and toolboxes available. For example, time series objects and import statements are not supported by MATLAB Coder.
So, there are limitations to MATLAB Coder. What other major limitations are there?
Even though MATLAB Coder is extremely useful, it does not support some of the most frequently used MATLAB features like scripts, GPU arrays, and try and catch statements.
I think it's better if we can see a small demo. Can we do that?
Sure, no worries.
And the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Let's start with a simple example that explains the basics of MATLAB Coder. Here I am inside of MATLAB, and I have a very simple algorithm called MyMul. All it does, it takes two numerical inputs called A and B, then multiply those together. Now in addition to this file, we have a test bench which is calling the function MyMul, with two values of 2.5 and 4. So simply, if you run this function, you get the result as expected, which is 10. Now we have a MATLAB function and a test bench file which calls the original function, and we are ready to generate code. Let's look at how we convert this MyMal MATLAB function into C or C++. You can go to apps, then from the drop down menu, code generation and the MATLAB coder. Or you can simply type coder command in the command window to open the MATLAB coder. Here you can see the first thing you need to tell MATLAB coder what file that you want to generate code for. In our case, it is a function called MyMal. Once you go through that, we need to specify the data types and sizes of our inputs. So we can do it manually, as you can see in the bottom part. Or the simpler way is to use the testbench file that we already created to call our function MyMal to quickly define input types. MATLAB coder will automatically detect the data types and sizes of the input arguments of the function. So after that, it is always good to check for runtime issues. In this process, MATLAB coder will build a max file, run it, and check whether there are any runtime issues. So you can see everything passed for this simple function and no problem. In this part of the process, we are ready to start generating code. As you can see in the dropdown, we can generate source code, max file, and static or dynamic library, and even an executable. Here, I will select the source code for now. Also, we can select what language that we are going to generate our code for. Let's select the C for the moment. Then click the Generate button with other default settings. Now the code generation is success. Let's take a look at our code generation report. In the bottom left are all the files that we generated, and in the mymal.c is the file where our C code is written according to the function. This is exactly how we write it in C code. For going further, let's make some changes to the initial MATLAB code. Suppose we want to multiply two matrices of size 2 by 2 and the size 2 by 3 with the my test page. If you run this file, you get a 2 by 3 matrix as a result. This is where the flexibility of code generation comes from. If we are writing the C code manually for this simple change, we have to write it from the beginning. But in MATLAB coder, you just want to change the input data types and code generation will take care of the rest. So we didn't change anything in our MyMal function. We changed only our test page. To regenerate the code, we just come back here and go back for our input define and auto define input types again. Now it identifies 2x2 and 2x3 as matrices. Here, for the simplification, I'll use exactly the matrices size instead of a range. Now go further. Do the code generation again. Open the report. So in mymal.c function, you can see the C code is changed according to the updated codes. Here, The C code is updated to multiply two sets of matrices with 2x2 and 2x3 together. So that was a quick and simple example. But for your school or industrial MATLAB projects, this can be further extended to handle complex functions and deploy auto-generated code on hardware quickly and easily.
Okay, now you guys have a basic understanding about what MATLAB code is. We hope that this introduction and demo were helpful to you.
If you guys enjoyed this excerpt, please like and share. If you have any suggestions, feedback, or questions, don't hesitate to comment.
We are planning to bring you more useful content from different tech fields in the future. So, to stay tuned, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. See you soon.